Welcome to Open Underwriter. We are an open source software house specializing in the development of IT solutions for the insurance market. We focus on enabling insurers and brokers to perform more effectively by providing a powerful, adaptable, and robust toolset that removes the traditional barriers associated with insurance software adoption, including high cost of ownership, slow time to market, and restrictive long-term contracts. In this video, we are going to provide an overview of some of the key features available in the Open Underwriter software suite. To start, we shall take a look at how Open Underwriter can help distribute your insurance products direct to market. Here we have an example broker website that has embedded within it the online quote and buy process for a product configured in Open Underwriter, in this case a travel product. The first part of the quotation process requires a proposal form to be completed, capturing details of the risk to be insured. For this demonstration, cover for a trip to Europe for one person is being requested. The proposal forms for products are highly configurable, providing full control over the questions to be asked, the order in which they are presented, and at what point in the process the risk is assessed and premium calculated. Portal technology is used by Open Underwriter to deliver these forms, allowing easy website integration and styling, but more on that later. As you can see, the risk details have now been assessed and premium calculated. In fact, for this product, three premiums offering different levels of coverage are provided for the proposer to select from. This product has been configured so once an offer for coverage is accepted, the proposer's personal details need to be completed before the premium is paid. However, with Open Underwriter, it is simple to specify the order in which you present pages or capture details. If you want your products to collect the contact details at the start of the proposal form, for example, you can. Next, we move on to premium collection. Here we are using PayPal. But Open Underwriter's payment module has been designed so it can easily integrate with other payment processing services as required. For demonstration purposes, we've connected to PayPal's sandbox environment, where the premium payment is being made using a test credit card number. The sandbox treats the credit card as genuine, although no real-world transaction actually occurs. If the product in Open Underwriter was configured to use the live PayPal environment, then only a real credit card would be accepted and a real financial transaction would take place. Depending upon payment success or failure, the process can be configured to return different pages to the user. For this product, a successful transaction allows a user to download a PDF policy certificate. Open Underwriter can generate quotation documents, certificates, wordings, and invoices which can be made available to the proposer for download or email directly to them. To review quotes and policies and monitor the performance of your products, you will need to log in to Open Underwriter. For the purposes of this demonstration, we are signing in as a user with comprehensive reporting and administration rights. The first area a user sees after signing in is their dashboard, configured to provide information important to that user's role. But before we go into detail about the dashboard, let's take a look at what happens to quotations and policies generated through the website. Under the policy menu item, a search facility allows you to find specific policies or quotes using their unique reference numbers, or enter criteria to return a list of matching policies and quotes from which you can select. Here, the policy we generated earlier on the website has been requested using the policy number and is now being displayed on the page. Policy cover, payment history, and associated documents can be located here. The layout and content shown on this policy page can be configured for individual products if required, allowing information from different products to be presented in a way that works best for the business. Open Underwriter also allows you to review the business activity of your organization through reporting. Reports are developed using BERT, an open source business intelligence and reporting toolset from Actuate, reports from which are made available to users under the reporting menu item. Here, a bordereau report is being requested. Users can set reporting criteria filters before the bordereau is generated, allowing for a great deal of control over the result set. Once available, the generated report can be viewed on the page and printed out if needed. However, the export facilities available for reports are even more useful, allowing data to be exported into a wide variety of different formats. It is possible to export data from specifically selected columns in any order, allowing the results to be used in other systems. Alternatively, the report can be exported as a whole and saved in a wide array of common file formats such as Excel, allowing for the information to be easily used and shared. If after generating a report, you need to refine the original criteria specified, or simply want to run the report with a new set of criteria, selecting a specific status, for example, you can. Here, the new business transactions only have been selected for reporting on. Earlier, we had a brief glimpse of the dashboard. So now let us take a closer look and see how it can be used to benefit both your business and your users. The dashboard is the place users arrive when they first log in to OpenUnderwriter. It is designed to provide an overview of all that is important to the individual user and their role. It can be configured specifically for the individual, allowing them to shape what is displayed to best fit their needs. New elements, known as portlets, can be added to the dashboard by simply selecting the portlet palette and dragging and dropping any portlets required onto the dashboard. Here, this process is being demonstrated using the OpenUnderwriter Policy Quick Search portlet, a portlet that allows you to quickly get an overview of a specific policy or quotation. The layout of portlets on the dashboard can easily be rearranged by the user. By simply turning Edit Mode on and dragging and dropping the portlets anywhere on the page, a user can create a layout that works best for them. Removing portlets is also an incredibly simple task. This example shows the dashboard primarily being used for management information reporting. But the variety of portlets available make it a useful tool for all types of role. One of the really powerful aspects of OpenUnderwriter is its versatile product development capability. The insurance product configurations themselves can be found under the Products menu item. The system allows any line of business to be implemented through configuration, and a single OpenUnderwriter installation is able to support as many different products as an organization requires. OpenUnderwriter uses a fully version-controlled environment to store the configurations, and these can also be accessed directly on a user's local PC using a network drive. Here, Windows Explorer is being used to navigate down to the risk assessment and rating rules that are part of the Star Insurance Travel product we obtained a quote from earlier. These rules are configured in an Excel spreadsheet, making it really intuitive for business users to understand and work with. In this rating sheet, you can see that the answers for a number of questions on the proposal form are being assessed and rated. A range of different rules can be applied in the rating sheet, including rules to set base premiums, loadings and discounts, both as fixed amounts and percentages, and the ability to refer or decline risks. To make a change to a rate, simply edit the value concerned, in this case, increasing the winter sports loading, and save the file. If at this point you close the spreadsheet, your changes will automatically be committed to the product configuration. But, as in this case, if you keep the file open, it remains as a draft version until you manually commit it. Selecting the file in the browser allows you to review the details about it, including its version history. Should you ever be required to do so, it is possible to revert back to an older version at any time. Whilst we always recommend making any product changes in a test environment before transferring them over to the live server, this ability to roll back quickly to a previous version does provide a really valuable safety net should anything go wrong. For example, if the wrong version of a rating sheet is uploaded by mistake, it can be reversed out very quickly. After changes to a product have been committed, they can be tested in the sandpit area. The sandpit is an area where the various aspects of an insurance product can be worked through and tested. In this particular example, we are testing that the change made to the winter sports loading on the travel product is being applied correctly. Here, the proposal form is presented and populated as on the Star Insurance website. However, the presentation of the form in the sandpit differs quite significantly. This is because the layout is controlled by style sheets, allowing a product to adopt different styles depending upon where it is being used. And the Star Insurance website has its own styles that ensure the proposal forms blend seamlessly into it. For this test, our first check is to confirm we did select winter sports coverage on the proposal form. We can see the premium quoted and the level of coverage offered varies between the three options being offered by this product. The sandpit provides an assessment sheet view, which provides a breakdown of how the premium was calculated. This allows us to see if the new 50% loading for winter sports coverage has been applied correctly or not. Here we can confirm that it has. The sandpit also provides an XML view. This really is getting into the guts of the product and demonstrates what the populated quotation looks like from a technical perspective. This structured document contains all the details entered on the proposal form and the premium breakdown. Later on in the process, it will also be populated with payment details. In this view, we can confirm that information has been correctly recorded by the product, such as the winter sports loading here, and that data entered on the proposal form has been saved as expected. The quotation process in OpenUnderwriter can be configured to send this XML to other systems. For example, this would enable the automatic uploading of new business into a back office policy administration system, allowing OpenUnderwriter to integrate into an organization's existing infrastructure. At the start of this demonstration, we visited the Star Insurance website. Now we are going to look at how Liferay, the open source enterprise content management system used by OpenUnderwriter, has been used to deliver that website and how it incorporated the OpenUnderwriter quotation process for the travel product. Liferay allows you to host and manage many websites at once through its administration console, and from here the Star Insurance website has been selected. Here we can configure various site parameters and metadata, or view it in a mode that allows its content to be edited directly. When viewing the site in edit mode, it looks much like any website would, but with some additional menu options. To edit content, you first select the menu option to enable editing, and then you select content you want to change. In this case, some text content has been selected, and a text editor has been provided to update the content. Simply edit the text, save the change, and the website is updated. A wide variety of different types of content and layouts can be utilized on the web pages, such as the use of Google Maps on the contact page. However, for the purposes of this demonstration, it is the OpenUnderwriter integration we are interested in, and the Get a Quote page on this website is a great example. Selecting the content preferences of the proposal form opens up a control that allows the selection of an OpenUnderwriter product and the process required. In this case, the travel product and the quotation process. Positioning the content on a page is simply a matter of dragging and dropping into the required position. The use of OpenUnderwriter products and processes isn't restricted to just Liferay. They can be integrated into a wide array of different platforms and are designed to work with existing websites. Another important aspect of any modern website is its ability to adapt to different devices, such as phones, tablets, laptops, and desktop PCs. Liferay provides an excellent tool to help you ensure your site will provide a great customer experience for all visitors, regardless of how they are viewing it. OpenUnderwriter itself is designed to deliver content that is compatible with responsive styling. In other words, content designed to be styled so it automatically adapts its layout to work well on the device being used to view the website. As we come to the end of this demonstration, I would like to thank you for taking the time to watch. I hope you have found it interesting and useful. If you would like to find out more about OpenUnderwriter, or would like to get in touch with us, then please visit our website at www.openunderwriter.com. where you will be able to find out our contact details and more information about the software.